Hello, welcome to Patrick Hatchcat's Place. This is Gina. I've got a couple of books I want to review and a new LP which is playing. Got this yesterday, the day before. It's a Time Life issue, the rock and roll era. Great LP, two LP set. Just his biggest hits. Oops. But again, I bought it because I love the cover. And the gatefold, the inside. And a great picture on the front. Okay, books. I'll go with the worst first. this book by Wanda June Hill called We Remember Elvis. I bought this thinking, well, she's says she's one of Elvis's closest friends and talked to him every day on the phone and rah, rah, rah. And you think, bullshit, lady. I mean, all the people have written and said that they knew Elvis and they talked to him every day. I mean, that's not including the Memphis Mafia, his entourage, and his girlfriends and so on. It would be nothing else but talk if you talked to all the people that said they talked to him. Now, this lady says her and her husband are good friends. And he even confided in her, and she's got all these conversations, in-depth conversations. The whole book is full of these conversations that she says she had with Elvis. And he was going to write a book, and he gave all her notes. There's a question and answer thing. And the thing that really annoys me is the way she writes. She makes Elvis sound like an idiot because he... how can I explain it? I'm just trying to find a part, she said. She writes in him talking in his southern accent. But she makes... I should start this again. Where is it? Oh, yeah, here we are. Okay. Yeah, I know my baby will go on to see this movie one day. How would she feel to see her daddy making it with some woman on a bed, foot screen and living colour? Got to think of that and don't think, I couldn't pull it off. There are a couple of photos. The usual standard photos, nothing special. And the other thing, you know, she said she was such a good friend of Elvis, she never met Priscilla. I think if she's a good enough friend, she probably would have met her somewhere along the way, but... Yeah, so I do not recommend that book. Now, the next one, Child Bride, is a very well-known one among the fans. And in view of the business going on with this latest film, Priscilla, I thought, I'll get this book. Well, it is an eye-opener. It's not sort of what I thought it was going to be. It's better. And as everybody that's read it says, it is well worth reading. It goes into Priscilla's background, her parents' background, and... toward the end of the book she talks to people and about Elvis after they split up and how Priscilla made a fool of Elvis in public several times when she was with him in front of their friends and family and so on. Made him look like an idiot. And how she never really loved him. She was infatuated with him when she was a child. And Elvis was, infatuated with her because she's so pretty. It was a disaster, really, from the start. He should never, ever let her come back to Graceland and live with him. Anyway, we can't change things, can we? So, yep, interesting book. I'm about halfway, about a quarter of the way through it. Very good reading. Now, this book I've had for a while, and I'm not going to try and talk over Elvis for the rest of the tape. This book is one of my favourites. Greater Than Ever, Elvis Presley, A Touch of Gold, Mama. It is one of, I think it's one of, what's his name? Can't remember. The Swedish guy, the Norwegian guy. I think it's, one of his books, anyway. The Elvis Files series. Okay, Elvis Eric Lorentzen. Okay. But great photos. Good text. And it's all about... the gold suit, when Elvis wore it, and why he didn't like it, and just sort of the history of it. along with other things that were happening in Elvis's life, of course, at the time. I mean, there's other photos in here as well, of course, but that's a cute one, isn't it, with the teddy bears? Unfortunately, a lot of the text is printed on the black background. I hate that, it's so hard to read. Very dark book to look at. Photos are dark, the text is dark. But there's a lot of great photos I haven't seen before. I haven't seen that one before. I can understand why Elvis wasn't too wrapped wearing the suit. The way he moved around, it would have been, it would have been hot and uncomfortable. I don't want to be tired. Lucky fan. God, he had his arms around four girls. In his element. That's a good shot. I'm doing this in front of the lounge room window because the glare of the kitchen fluorescent light just gets too much sometimes, so this is the best I can do. I don't want to be a tiger, cause tiger's way too rough. I don't want to be a lion, cause lions ain't the kind you love and love. Haha, those skirts. Sleep, what's that? Poor Elvis. Elvis Presley fans, 24,000 strong and all screaming. Can you imagine singing in front of that many people? There's him and the band up there. I mean, it would have been pretty intimidating for the band members too, of course, and the backing singers. Especially in the early days when it was just Scotty and Bill and DJ. Oh, the Jordanaires, of course, too. Elvis wiggles and wails as 24,000 scream and sob. Yeah, the different new. I love this, where they actually reprint the newspaper coverage of Elvis's concert in the early days. And a puss, what do you want? Cats come up to see what I'm doing. Hysterical shrieks greet Elvis in his gold jacket and shoes. Elvis sings, swings, leaves thousands in teens hoarse from yelling and screaming. I love the way God. And that's another reason why I didn't wear the trousers, the gold trousers, because he'd get down on his knees so often he started to wear them out. Cross-legged and squat. You know, he was so fit right up until his later years. The fact that he could sit cross-legged and squat down and kneel down and jump up so quickly, I guess it was the karate training, or toward later years anyway, but God, he was fit. Not many people could do what he did. I mean, physically, I don't mean singing, well, that too. But, in Toronto, the full gold suit. You know, I wonder if he could have fit into that suit, probably would have, when he was in his mid-30s. Imagine if he'd walked out to the stage in Las Vegas instead of a jumpsuit, in his gold suit. Oh God, I wish he had it. It would have been unbelievable. Even if he just walked out in there and done a couple of songs, then walk back and change and come back out and something else. But imagine getting that on a video. Now, where are we up to? I have to change records. I did a woman. Yep. Okay, excuse me for a moment, I'll just go and flip the record over. Actually, put another record on. I've already paid side one of that. I know only about possibly 10. Sitting up there with jewels. Funny man. All evening. Family twilight. I love that shot. Wow. Oh. A lot of people are out of control. God, it's gorgeous. You know, I don't think I'd look through all through this book. I'd flick through it maybe for a while, but no, I haven't. I don't remember looking at all these photos, so this is the first time for me to... I'm sorry about this background. My coffee table's got a Japanese fabric mat on it, and I probably should have shaken it off. It could be a bit distracting. I'm trying to avoid filming it, but a bit hard. The closer his knees came to the floor, the louder became the screams. No, I won't be lucky. There will never be anyone like Elvis, ever, ever again. Halfway through. Before. I need to go a bit faster, but if I go faster, you'll miss stuff. I'm up to 18 minutes already on this video. Love his profile. Great God. Rhythm in the day, blues in the night. If he doesn't slow down, he may burn himself out. Rock and Roll Rivals magazine, 1957. How right they were. That's what I reckon he did. He burned himself out. Oh, that game. I had that game. Philadelphia rocks while the prizzy rolls. church is long. God, all the fans at the sort of train. Oh, get the back up. Geez, young there, isn't he, old Colonel? Battery is not going to last out, I don't think, for this one. Maybe I should have fun. Should have just made this book a whole thing on its own, instead of starting with the two other ones. Not. If it battery dies, I'll just... leave the book open where it finishes and start again with a new battery, or a fresh battery later on. Let's go. Flick through it a bit faster. A lot of photos of the fans. Prizzly fans demented. Oh, next thing I knew, I was body the cop. Oh. What's he doing there? Sitting on the edge of the table, look, he had the journalist in the palm of his hand every time, didn't he, wherever he went. Look at that. Just fascinated, hypnotised by Elvis. There's a lot of really good photos here. And he was so casual, you know, just sitting on the edge of the table, talking to them like they were friends. Is holding out so far. So we're nearly at the end.
Are you lonesome tonight? Do you miss me? Are you sorry we drifted apart?
God, he looked good in a suit. Oh, he looked beautiful. I can just imagine him, the CEO of a big company.
Wow. You read your lines so cleverly and made Mr. Q. Then came Act Two. Using the change, you acted smart. Why am I not? Honey, you lie. When you said you left, and I had no cause to doubt. But I'd rather go on hearing your lies.
That's a nice one too, at the piano, his gold suit.
Now the stage is bare, and I'm standing there.
They're nearly finished. I think the battery's going to hold out. Yeah, that was a bit raunchy, wasn't it? When he was using the dog. Naughty Elvis, that was unnecessary. Okay, well that record's finished. Book's just about finished. Is that Elvis there? Yeah. Uncensored. Flip over the last few pages. You just about made it. Tiger. Oh, that's a nice one. That's the year when he lost from the little gold, the gold jacket, I guess. Elvis Files books. Phew, we made it. Thanks for your patience. I hope you enjoyed that. It certainly is worth getting that. I know I say that about a lot of books, but yeah, a lot of money, but a brilliant, wonderful book full of absolutely fantastic photos. Bye for now.